what Afenifere is saying, why they are sitting in the office defending their own people. Let's take one or two sentences. The Yoruba Sociocultural Organization, Afenifere, has tackled the Arewa Consultative Forum over its comments on the violence in the Ibarapa local government area of Oyo State, warning the forum should not make inflammatory statement. Warning. If you see a man, he will look like a man. Come on. Igbo si na amo nwoke oburu nwoke ka oburu ya buru nwoke amo nwoke ka oburu nwoke. You know, if you see a man, you start, it's not that you are a man. And just like the video I saw of Joe Biden employing somebody, a man telling a fellow man that is his husband, you know, foolishness, and you are clapping hand for all this foolishness. A whole world leader, this is the first thing he could be able to display. I can never support evil. I don't care who the ox is, go, don't care. You know, this is what to display the first time coming into the office. You know, if you are a man, you stand like a man. Not that you are a man, but you are wearing pampers. It's not good. Come on, look at what Afenifere is telling to Iowa Consultative Forum face to face. Can such a thing come from the so-called Ohanaeze? Can such a thing come from a pandef of those that answer English names? You know, see an old man answering English name. What is your tribe? We don't know. That is why some people will come out and say he's not Igbo. Then which your tribe? You don't know. Look at the statement. Let me repeat it again, because I may not read the whole things there. The Yoruba Social Cultural Organization, Afenifere, has tackled the Arewa Consultative Forum over the comment on the violence in the Ibarapa local government area of Oyo State, warning the forum should not make inflammatory statement. Afenifere stated that while the ACF has never shown any remorse over the killing of our people, The organization is still now threatening to repeat the civil war. Afenifere is saying, speaking like a man, speaking like a cultural group. The Afenifere National Publicity Secretary Yinka Odumakin, in a statement on Saturday, noted that the criminals must be arrested. Otherwise, our people cannot sheepishly wait to be killed by those who value cow's life more than human being. Look at the statement that is coming from the Afenifere's office. Look at the statement. Not like all these slaves, we are perfect slave. Igbo, anything Igbo, anything about us is perfect slave to the Fulani, perfect one, not just ordinary, a perfect one. You can't hear such a thing. You cannot hear such a thing. Rather, devil mine will send military to kill his own people that elected him. You know, the Fulani Supreme Court administrator in Imo State, to Kebeke, will only give up Kebeke to empower his own youth. You know, these are the nonsense you'll be seeing. Mwike will command the military men to shoot people in Obi. These are the kind of things you will be seeing from our own. Jordan Nyamwodo will go to the meeting and be singing Mwike, 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 Kaigeso. These are the things you will be hearing from them. But look at Afenifere putting a statement, standing with their two feet, supporting their own. Before this thing happened, there was the news I read. The whole traditional rulers were in support of their governor. Nobody opposed. Nobody sneak out and go to Abuja. Nobody call Abuja to sabotage the man. Because these are the things you see in Igbo land. Everybody want to connect to the president. So the process, he will be selling his own people. And the land is dying. Nothing like that, my dear brother. They were together defending their own people. Asking an Arewa Consultative Forum, why you did not react when they were killing the indigenous people of Oduduwa? You know? I love this news so much. You know, while we have gone to a great length to sue for the peace and have appealed to our pained people to be law-abiding, even with the daily provocation of the Fulani and the harassment of our people, will frown on the very arrogant, insulting Iowa Consultative Forum statement, especially their reference to the event of 1966. People have forgotten that the 1966 of a thing. You remember the statement, the Iowa Consultative, that it can trigger something from the north and they begin to kill. Because they did that one, nobody, nothing, up to today, nobody talks about that. Kill innocent Igbo people for necessarily. Unnecessarily, something that have to connect with the military, with the government, you went out and be killing civilians, and they are proud of such statements. They are proud of it. Igbo activists cannot react on this now. You see why our people, our activists, they are foolish. People like Chido Dinkakalo, what's her name? Due process. This Obasanjo's girlfriend, what's her name? Ezekwesiri. Many of them, you can't see them talking now, tweeting, say, why will you bring, so you are not sorry about the murder of our people. You know, if you watch that movie, Half of Yellow Moon, Half of Yellow Sun, of what's this sister that have sold herself now, Chimamanda, you know, if you watch, you see, so you have some understanding of what happened in that night, how our people were being killed left and right, and that is what they were referring to. In other words, they are not sorry of what they did. They are going to do it again. Your own activist, this is the time an activist is supposed to react over this, that statement. You can never hear any Igbo man, Igbo activist, according to our leader, holding pen and paper, patrolling himself in Abuja, looking for who to serve, you know, to react over those statements. They will keep quiet. But immediately anything will happen now within the north, you see them, they will come and conduct a conference doing peace for them, let them have peace, whatever. That is the useless thing you see them. They cannot stand like a man. Their own son that is standing, instead of them to support him, they want to kill him. That is why we will start this cleansing from our home. All these wicked and stupid and useless people we have should go down. Short and simple, we form a new breed that will be giving praise to Almighty. You know, they are referring you to 1966 coup, pogrom, the worst of its kind. They are referring you. It's just like in Rwanda now, somebody to rise up and talk about boast of something that thing they happened in April. In Rwanda, the genocide of Rwanda, it's just like somebody to come. Nobody will be quoting it in a positive way, or using it as a threat, or reminding you something. Nobody from that side now. That is exactly what Arewa Consultative Forum are doing, telling the Afenifere's, but thinking that Afenifere will be afraid of them. No. They are not the Biafran people, the Igbo people that they have swallowed completely. You know, we must understand what is going on. We must make it, let's continue saying, we must make it clear to them that they cannot threaten us with a war at this stage, as we will not provoke war, but never are we going to run for anybody on our land. You see the statement of the Afenifere? That let the Arewas never threaten them with war, but they are not going to run away from. You see how a man speaks, an intelligent man. You know, if you digest all this word, you understand that these people are ready, they are prepared, they support their own, they will never back these people from their statement. Can it come out from your land, from Mohaneze, from Pandef? Can it come out from there? The answer is no. That is why we are speaking this thing. Can Pandef react in this way? Can they react in this way? The answer is no. It's not taking gun, going to bush, gathering some people, put say Biafra, you are shooting gun. Pa, 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 pa. These are terrorists too. We must know, because they don't have leader. Let the leader of those group come out and show their faces. Let the leader come out and show their faces, you know, because we know what they are planning. They are planning to sabotage, to jettison what we are doing. So we must expose them. They must be exposed. Very, very important. Because if they have a genuine intention, even Boko Haram has a leader. Shekau always come and do video. How can somebody tell you that they are army? They don't have a leader. Huh? Shekau, who is the head of the terrorists, always come out and show his face. Let's continue with the statement of Afenifere. Is so beautiful, so sweet. You know, when I go through this news, I was so happy. Because this Fulani not done plague whatever a war of a nonsense, you know. These people have been enjoying this evil zoological as if they own everybody. As if they can say whatever they want to say, as if they have monopoly of killing. Could you imagine at this time opening the border, bringing people you don't know from Futajelon, evil people you don't know, the kind of no peace and nothing? They will go inside the forest and build houses and stay there. Not house, they will build huts and stay there. From there, they will be coming to terrorize people, taking people's land by force. You know, I love the statement. These are the kind, if somebody like a judge Ubiozo begin to say this kind of thing, I'm telling you, I will be number one advocate that will fight anybody that will speak against them. If such a statement now begin to come out of Ohanaeze, being led by this selected leader called George Obiozo, Professor George Obiozo, if such a statement be coming from their offices, I'm telling you, Iwa Chineke will be number one advocate for them, defending them. If you write against them or say anything against them, I will attack you. You know? But can you hear such a thing from them? The answer is no, because they are not ready. Because we have seen the statement they have uttered at this time, that they are just newly elected, how they were prepping, pampering words, you know, pampering words, knowing, being careful of what they are saying about their own thing, how they are releasing it, so that the oga on the top, the oga Fulani on the top, will not react, so that they can deceive some gullibles that they call their own people. The gullibles will be deceived, you know, those kind of things, you know. That is the statement. That statement you heard him in that 18 minutes video clip, you know. That is the game he was playing there. We are no more foolish, you know. We our eyes are open. The biggest thing you will give to somebody is to educate him, and that is what Mazin Nnamdi Kanu has done to us. You know, there is no any statement somebody will make now that we will not understand where he's going or where he's coming from or what he wants. So our eyes are open, our brain are working perfectly. You know, let's finish this news from this statement from Ariwa Consultative, no, from Afenifere. We are miffed that a body like Ariwa Consultative Forum that has never shown any remorse over the killing of our people can now open their mouth. You know, Afenifere is reacting. These people, Ariwa Consultative Forum, have been there. They are killing Dodudua people in their land by their own imported Fulani. They have never reacted, but it is now that they are reacting. Let's continue. Recall that Ariwa Consultative Forum earlier had demanded that the federal and the Oyo State government apprehend the perpetrators and the instigate of the violence in the Iganga Ibara local government area of the state, where the house and the property of Alhaji Salisu Abdul Karid, the Serikim Fulani, were destroyed. They were conditioning these people to pay for them. Why would they pay? Is the land the man's land? Let him go to naught. One thing we must understand with these present Fulanis that are living in, that are trying to live in the south. Listen, if you are in the north now, or you have lived in the north, you bear me witness. There is no any Nigerian northerner. There is no any zoologian Nigerian northern Fulani or Hausa, whatever you claim, that would like to live north and come and live in the south. I'm telling you, they don't like it. Watch those ones that come to do their business, like bringing their tomato cow and whatever. As they finish, they will just go back. There is no any in the people that have been living, the Fulanis that are living in the north, and the whoever was that, none of them would like to relocate to come and settle in the east, or they don't like it. I know they are alive. They don't like problem. They like to stay on their own. They will tell you that place is too rough, this too rough, too this, too that. The whole Fulani you see, the whole Hausa people you see in the south, is either they're under governmental, they are like diplomat, maybe police officer, military officer, being posted for one federal work. Maybe on the process they may decide to stay there, like in places like Enugu. Apart from that, the other people you see that are floating, those ones are not people in Nigeria. We must tell you that they are not the Afulanis or the Hausas that have been living in Nigeria before. None of them will have the temerity, the heart, to move out from the north and go to south and stay. Mark this thing. If you have never investigate what I'm telling you. I have a lot of friends in the north. In those days, tell them, just come, let's go to Onitsha. He won't, he will give you money. Say, go, bye. He don't want to go there. He don't want. Even that time that their area is very peaceful. Now you are seeing people coming, claiming that they are Arewa people, living inside a bush. And people are keeping quiet.